In this question, it says a block kept on a rough inclined plane as shown in the figure remains at rest up to a maximum force 2 newton down the inclined plane, and the maximum external force up the inclined plane that does not move the block is 10 newton. These are the forces at which the friction will be maintained at limiting friction so that block does not move. Now it is asking the coefficient of static friction between block and plane. So here the two cases will analyze separately, and here we can see when block tendency is for downward sliding. So this would be the case when block is experiencing mg sin theta in downward direction and friction mu mg cos theta will be in upward direction. So downward force is say F1, and the maximum limit of F1 at which it can slide is 2 newton. So here for limiting equilibrium, we use F1 plus mg sin theta is equals to mu mg cos theta. So this giving us, F1 is given to us as 2 newton, this 2 is equals to mu mg cos theta, theta we write later 30 degree minus it is mg sin theta. This is our equation 1. And we can write when external force acts upward. So in that case we can see when external force acts upward, in that case it will have a tendency to slide up. So mg sin theta will be acting down, and friction at the bottom mu mg cos theta at limiting value would also be acting down. The force F2 is acting in upward direction. So here we can write for limiting equilibrium, here we use F2 is equals to mg sin theta plus mu mg cos theta. This is our equation 2, and here if we just substitute the value of F2, which is given to us as 10 newton, here we can see from the two equations, here if we substitute the values, you can see what we are getting. This will be giving us 10 is equals to mg sin theta plus mu mg cos theta. Say this is equation 2 instead of this equation after substituting the value 10. Now from here we can add the 2 and subtract the 2. This will give us the values of mg sin theta and mg cos theta. So we can see here 1 plus 2 will result. If we add the 2, this will give us 12 is equals to 2 mg cos theta. So this is giving us 6 is equals to mu mg cos 30 degree, which is say equation 3, and 2 minus 1 gives 10 minus 2, this will be giving us 8 divided by 2 is 4 is equals to mg sin 30 degree. Say this is our equation 4, and in this case if we divide the equations, here this gives 3 by 4, this gives 3 by 2 is equals to mu times cot 30 degree, that is equals to root 3 mu. So this giving us the value of mu is equals to root 3 by 2, and here it matches with the option B. So answer to this question will choose option B.